It's quiet here in India Point Park now, but next month there will be music in the air.
John Denver drew 15,000 people to India Point 2 years ago, and city officials are hoping this summer's concert series will be a repeat performance popularity-wise. Chicago, Heart, Starship, Dan Fogelberg, Moody Blues, and Crosby, Stills, and Nash are tentatively scheduled. The concerts will be on weeknights, June through September, and limited to 12,000 people.
It's the city's only waterfront park. It's a beautiful piece of property that's not really very well used, and we want it a way to not only provide people with nice concerts, but a way to introduce them to this beautiful park.
A lot of the college students down here that hang out in the summer, and I don't think there's a lot to do, but I think this would give it a lot more to do.
More to do without costing the city a dime. Promoter Frank Russo is paying for everything from police protection to a special shuttle for people who park downtown. If all goes well, 30% of the proceeds will go to the city. But to many who live near the park, it all sounds too good to be true.
I think they'll draw crowds from Boston to Hartford. And despite the fact you're restricting sales to 12,000, I think you're going to draw 30,000. And they're all going to be all over the place.
But Providence Senator Sean Coffey says downtown parking and extra police should keep things under control. If not, Mayor Paolino has an out.
If the concert causes any kind of a threat either to the public health or safety, or even causes some substantial inconvenience to the people in the neighborhood, he can on that basis terminate the concert.
If the concert series is successful, it could have a spin-off effect. City officials say they plan to use any proceeds from the concerts to sponsor programs in other city parks. Mary McGuire, Newswatch 10, Providence.